Are you tired of people getting rich off of your dreams? Are you tired of doing your podcast for free? Well, I encourage people to check out the Anchor app because you can have ads, you can have commercials, and you can have a wide viewing audience. And you can speak your mind and get paid for it. And not to mention, it's free. Anchor will distribute your podcast from Spotify to Apple. You can make money from your podcast with no minimum listenership. It's everything you need to make it in a podcast. This is Kingknown NBA and Music Talk, endorsing Anchor.
Now, I know y'all gotta get on y'all shit. How the fuck y'all not listen to my last shit? I ain't begging y'all, cause I don't give a fuck. That one listen probably worth more, probably like three of y'all's. So, yeah, man. I'm tired. Hey. Motherfucking tired.
Got to pay back.
Motherfucking tired.
Man.
I don't want to do this. I really don't.
A man. Got to get back. I need some get back.
I definitely need some because
payback.
Y'all LeBron fans are getting on my goddamn nerves.
Goddamn. Payback.
For real. Especially ESPN.
I'm mad. Get down.
And y'all is disrespectful to the Utah Jazz, the best team in the NBA, record-wise. All right, cut it, cut it, cut it, cut it, cut it, cut it. All right, cut that shit, man. Let's get to business, man. Let's stop playing with these niggas. All right. All-star choices and snubs. As y'all can see, I'm out on the road right now, riding back to the crib. I might as well. I just said, fuck it. All-star, all-star, all-star. Now, if you listen to my previous show, which a lot of y'all pussy niggas didn't, fuck y'all. I didn't have D-Book on my all-star list, and I had CP3. I have to admit it. I mean, I put his numbers up against Ingram's and Zion's, and I went with Ingram and Zion, but Ingram didn't make it either, but all right, let's check the all-star teams. Let's talk the whole team, man. The reserves were named. They were named, y'all. And a lot of people were outraged that Devin Booker was not on the original list. He's in now. He's an all-star now. But let's go over this. All right, Anthony Davis. This is the West right here. Western Conference All-Stars. We had Ant Davis, PG, Rudy Gobert, Dame Lillard, Donovan Mitchell, Chris Paul, and Zion Williamson. It almost looks like mine. Because I had Ingram replacing Davis. It almost looks identical to mine. All right, East, we got Jaylen Brown, James Harden, Zach LaVine, Julius Randle, Ben Simmons. I don't know about that one. I would not have voted. Well, then again, I think I might have voted for him to get in too, maybe. I don't remember. I don't have that list on me right now. Jason Tatum and Nikola Vucevic. Vooch got in. Yeah, I didn't. I know I didn't vote for Ben Simmons' ass to get in. He don't deserve to be an all-star in my book. That's just me. But shout outs for Vucevic, man. He's underrated. But there were a lot of snubs, man. A lot of snubs. Sabonis, big snub. Big giant snub. Tobias Harris was a snub. Fuck this nigga doing. Anyway, yeah, Tobias Harris, big snub. I need to list the teams. Because this shit here, like, it was a few snubs. Oh, Trey Young, Ice Trey. Yeah, Ice Trey was a big snub. Ice Trey. Big snub. Big, huge snub. I'm not going to say Middleton, whether he was a snub or not. Not really sure about that. But other than that, yeah, that's all I got for that All-Star talk. Lakers got the shit beat out of them. Last night was a big game for the Utah Jazz. I mean, it wasn't really that big to begin with, to be honest. This was just an ass whooping. They got the shit stomped out of them. You know what's funny? When I posted this, Lakers fans was like, oh, it's just a regular season when AD come back, yeah, yeah, yeah. But when LeBron beats a team without their three best players, he's the GOAT. He's the greatest of all time. Why can't we have our moment to talk shit too? Why can't we joke when it comes to LeBron at LeBron's expense, but we can joke about Paul George hitting the side of the fucking backboard? That's that Bron privilege shit that I be talking about. But anyway, it was an ass whooping, 89-114, as Donovan Mitchell continues to assert himself as an MVP candidate and is battling, in my personal opinion, with Joel Embiid for the MVP. I think him and Mitchell is right on each other. I'm not even going to look at the stats. This was just embarrassing. I'm like, they quit. The Lakers just flat out quit against the Jazz. The Jazz bought out that Bidum, and the motherfuckers got all shook up. Oh. Now, here's a big question. Is trade number 43 coming? Is 42 Bron, 42 Doug, James gonna go turn into 43 Doug? Is trade number 43 coming? Because, you know, Anthony Davis, you know, I know there's been rumors the Lakers been looking for a third star to go with AD and LeBron for the longest. Are they trying to get Beal? Or are they just going to make a regular trade to bring different role players in? I just want to know. Because all these ESPN, FS1 niggas, they're advocating for a trade. They're saying LeBron needs help. No, LeBron just needs AD. If AD's value does not show, let me take you back to 2018. Where, you know, they went 37-45. And then with Anthony Davis, they win one of the easiest championships of all time. Because LeBron and AD as a duo made it so easy. But I had told one of my niggas, like, this is going to be the Kingknown talking shit. We going to bring it back to that era. Newsflash. LeBron James for MVP is over. It is done. Kaputsky. It's a wrap. I don't give a fuck if it is year 18 and he's 36 years old. I don't care. That's not a good excuse anymore. Yes, he is playing at a very elite level at the age of 36. I respect that. That's not my issue, though. My issue is using that to validate his greatness over other all-time greats. That's my problem. But LeBron, for the greatest of all time, you know, after this little stretch right here, you guys, LeBron for the greatest of all time, it never existed. That LeBron can carry anybody narrative is dead. Now, yes, as a 23-year-old, he can do that, but not as a 38-year-old man in his 16th season. He cannot do that. This is the proof right here that they need Anthony Davis on that court because he could be a decoy or he could take over a game. This is showing how special Davis really is. I was wondering why he was playing so bad. And this man is playing with a fucked up Achilles. Tendonitis. But anyway, sticking to the subject. A lot of Lakers people, a lot of people on the internet, a lot of LeBron fans, just people in general are comparing the current Utah Jazz, the number one seed in the Western Conference. Let me tell y'all something. When, in my Nino Brown voice, let me tell y'all something. Great. Let me learn you something. This is the Western Conference we're talking about here. This is not the Eastern Conference. And we're going to make a little comparison here. The Western Conference, Utah has to play the Clippers three or four times. Utah's got to play the Lakers three or four times. Utah has to play the Phoenix Suns three or four times. Utah has to play the Portland Trail Blazers three or four times. Utah has to play the San Antonio Spurs three or four times. Utah has to play the Golden State Warriors three or four times. Dallas Mavericks three or four times. Denver Nuggets three or four times. Memphis Grizzlies three or four times. New Orleans Pelicans three or four times. Okay? That's what y'all failing to realize, how difficult it is to win against Western Conference opponents. And these guys are 26-6. This team is 15-4 at home and 11-4 on the road. Everybody's comparing them to the 60-22 Hawks, the 2014-15 Atlanta Hawks. That is so disrespectful. You want to know why? Let me tell you why. I'll tell you what. I'm going to put this narrative to the dirt right now. You mean to tell me that I got questions, man. I got a lot of questions. Is Elton Brand at that stage of his career in 2015 better than Donovan Mitchell, Rudy Gobert, or Mike Conley? Because let me tell you, Damari Carroll, who was an all-star that year, was not better than Conley, Gobert, and Mitchell. Neither was Korver, neither was Millsap at that stage of his career, despite him having one of the best seasons of his career. Dennis Schroeder was not better. Jeff Teague was not better than those three guys. A one-legged Thabo Sefolosha was not better than those three. Al Horford was not better than Conley, Gobert, or Mitchell. Are they even better than Joe Ingles or Royce O'Neal? Shit, these niggas is on George's Niang level. Shit, Clarkson better than them three niggas, right? Then Clarkson is better than everybody on that. Jordan Clarkson is better than everybody on that 2014-2015 Atlanta Hawks roster. Now let's look at that year in perspective. In the Eastern Conference, when Atlanta won 60 games, right? There were only three 50-win teams in the whole entire conference. So if you take Atlanta out of the equation, right? The Cavaliers and the Bulls were the only teams in the East to win 50 games. Meanwhile, if you look at the records right now, there were two teams that didn't win 20 games. And the Orlando Magic that won 25 games. So you mean to tell me that the Atlanta Hawks were playing the 76ers, who won 18 games 4 times. The New York Knicks 4 times, who won 17 games. The Orlando Magic, who won 25 games 4 times. The Detroit Pistons, who won 32 games 4 times. Look at how many under 500 teams there were in the East that year. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And then Milwaukee Bucks were at 500. So technically it's 9 500 and under teams that they had to play 4 times. Of course they were going to win 60 games. The Cleveland Cavaliers won 53 games. And guess who their coach was, the Atlanta coach, who I hate the most, Mike Budenholzer. They were poorly coached and won 60 games. That was fool's gold. That was a Cinderella story. Okay? So stop disrespecting Donovan Mitchell and Rudy Gobert, two all-stars who were better than everybody on that team. There are 4 players on the Jazz that are better than that whole fucking roster. You miss me with that bullshit talk. And not to mention, that Hawks team still made it to the conference finals. Although they got swept, they were also injured. Paul Millsap was playing hurt. Damare Carroll was playing hurt. Kyle Korver got hurt in game 2 and missed that whole series. So, I don't want to fucking hear about the 60-22 Hawks compared to the Jazz that have only lost 5 games and had a way more difficult schedule and a way more difficult conference. So cut the bullshit. Denzel Curry and Kenny Beats are set to drop their Unlock 1.5. I'm pretty sure I can go get the leak right now. Can't wait to hear that. And Payroll and Cardo are dropping a new project tonight. I can't wait to hear that. I told y'all about Brad Stevens. Now the Celtics, if the playoffs were to begin now, they would be out of the playoffs and would be in the play-in game. Can you believe that? It seems like the players have stopped responding to Brad Stevens. It's time for Danny Ainge to make that move and cut ties with dead weight. There are so many overprivileged white coaches in the league right now. Not to say that Brad Stevens is a bad coach. I'm not trying to say that. I am trying to say is he's just got the privilege. He's a good coach. He could coach a mediocre team to a playoff team, but he's not a championship winning coach when he's fell short in multiple conference finals with the talent that he has had. But this is very disappointing to have Jaylen Brown and Jason Tatum, surefire all-stars, and Kimbrick Walker, who is a borderline all-star. Last but not least, Kyle Lowry has sparked a lot of trade interest. The Toronto Raptors are trying to shop Kyle Lowry before he becomes a free agent next season, but the Clippers have interest. Like I told you on those trade shows, that the Clippers should trade for Kyle Lowry because he already knows how to play with Serge Ibaka and Kawhi Leonard. Miami Heat are also interested, and the Philadelphia 76ers. Shit, I honestly would trade Ben Simmons for Kyle Lowry. I'm not going to lie to you. Ben Simmons just don't have that aggression. Kyle Lowry knows how to turn it on. I'd do that trade straight up. No hard feelings. Get your bitch ass out of here. But, you know, they're not going to do that. But my thoughts are... You know, Lowry should go to the Clippers. The Miami Heat could use them too. That would be a tough guy. Miami would be so tough with him and Jimmy Butler and Duncan Robinson and shit. It depends on who they give up for him. I think that the Clippers would have to give up a few pieces to get Lowry, though. That's the only problem, but... I didn't serve it up too raw. But, yeah, that's my show, man. Short little show. Hope y'all enjoy y'all night. Have a good one. Fuck you very much.